Welcome to Die Trying.
Crack kills screen.
I'm Patty Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
And today we're going to be replacing broken screens.
Broken screens.
Broken screens.
Hey. Microwaves.
Microwaves. Well, actually, so this thing right here is an I.O. pair. What you're holding right there is an iPad 2, which much like a number of, like, I want to say the Samsung 5, the Motorola Moto G, which ironically has a broken screen also, uses glue to hold the screen down onto the phone. Now, if you're lucky, you've got like a newer iPhone 5 or 5S, it's a couple of screws, and it's easy by comparison.
No, this is the lucky one because this smells delicious.
It does smell delicious.
Get an iPad 2 and then break it so you can fix it with this.
Should we start opening?
Yeah.
Hey, really good idea before you start prying off your old screen is to get some tape and tape over the glass. That'll help keep the shards and fragments in one place that is not your face or fingertips. I'm not guaranteeing you won't have any bits of glass flying up, so putting on safety goggles is a really good idea for this project. One of the nice things about the iPad devices is that the crew over at iFixit have really detailed instructions on how to do just about everything, including, in this case, replacing the front panel. And they do that for lots of devices. For example, other cell phones, and they're even trying to put together things like how to repair your washing machine and stuff. So in this case, we're gonna put this thing you're looking at right here. The tube is an eye opener. You heat it for 2 or 3 minutes in the microwave, and you let it sit for 90 seconds on your screen, and that's how it softens the glue. So according to the crew at iFixit, we should be able to find a gap in the adhesive ring in the upper right corner of the iPad, about 5 centimeters down.
Something's happening. I don't know if it's a good thing, but it's happening. All right, so mid screen repair status. Things are going great so far. The iPad still turns on, which is more than we expected. And we pried off the digitizer kind of on accident, but luckily the screen that we have has the digitizer attached.
The idiot savant buys again.
But the cool thing is right now, the old one's still attached, so we can still control things. All right, so we're gonna keep peeling off all these bits and hopefully
eventually someday we'll be done.
Make things work, I don't know.
So there's 4 screws to loosen up the LCD.
Isn't that fun? In the process of peeling up the screen, we accidentally broke the Wi-Fi antenna in half. So, in the meantime, while we're waiting for those parts to ship, I got started on our friend Kendall's iPhone 5 screen. This, in theory, should be a little less painful than the iPad. I took off the bottom screws, pulled off the screen, and then removed the little metal shield holding down all of the connectors. At this point, I could have swapped in the new screen, but since this is die trying and nothing is ever simple, I also had to clean out the camera lens because there was a bunch of junk underneath there, which required pulling out the whole logic board to get under the camera module. Fun! But after cleaning everything out, the process of putting it back together was just as easy. Just be careful with those little connectors.
Oh, I'm really nervous about this part.
You should be.
All right, so the moment of truth, turning on the phone and seeing if it actually works. I see an apple, that's a good sign.
Good sign. That's more than I expected.
Screen's working. I have a message, you guys can't see that.
Thank you.
So camera, let's see. Kind of hard to do. Yay! Camera's working.
What
say hello.
The selfie camera.
selfie camera.
That one I didn't think
about. Oh wait.
Okay, come on.
Uh oh.
Well, I guess I had a little bit more work to do, but Pat's parts came in, so go to him.
A day later and a couple of overnight shipments from Amazon.com, and we had a replacement Wi-Fi antenna and a replacement home button. The Wi-Fi antenna is pretty easy, you just have to pull up the logic board. The home button's a little trickier because you have to mount the home button in the screen, then the switch to the screen, and then hope you got it in exactly the right spot so it'll actually touch the contacts in the bottom half of the iPad 2 case. Once the home button was working, it was time to peel off all of this 3M adhesive and apply it to the screen so we could sandwich the iPad back together. And hey, check it out, working iPad people.
which makes it just about perfect to watch videos from our sponsor, lynda.com/DIY. If you haven't been there, lynda.com's pretty amazing. It's a collection of video tutorials from everything on programming, video editing. I mean, professional skills, you want to gain them. You don't have a lot of time to go to school. You should definitely check out lynda.com/DIY, and we want to thank them for sponsoring this episode of Die Trying.
After jiggling a few wires, I was ready for Kendall to try out the iPhone again.
Yay, is it working?
You tell me.
Okay. Camera. Selfie.
Yeah.
Yay. Awesome.
We did it.
That sucked.
I was fine.
Yeah, okay, so iPhone 5.
iPhone 5, it's like two screws and then some ribbon cables if you have the complete front assembly. Yeah. So easy.
Microsoft Surface. Okay, 8 of you own that. iPad 2s, many of the iPads, a bunch of Samsung devices, Motorola, Moto X, Moto G, all have glue-on screens. And the glue was a nightmare, right? Because you have to heat the glue, remove the screen. In the process of removing the screen, we tore off the Wi-Fi antenna and broke the home button. We also removed some of the extra bit of trim, so you know, I'm gonna have to like sort of silicone that down on. Mm-hmm. Glue-on screens suck. You know, in 2020 hindsight, I'd have spent $100 to replace this screen in a heartbeat. Have somebody
else do it.
What he said.
Yeah. Before you actually invest in getting a new screen, check out what goes into it. Because maybe it'll be fine, or maybe it'll be that iPad.
Well, yeah, it's kind of funny because you can buy the LCD, or excuse me, you can buy the glass in some cases, but that would mean, for example, if you bought the glass for this iPhone 5, you would have to remove all of these components like the home button, the LCD screen, the digitizer, the earpiece, the front-facing camera, and I guarantee you're going to break half of them, if not all of them. But for $30, we found one that was completely populated. That's what made it so fast to turn over. You know, whether or not it is as good as the original glass on this, we'll read the reviews, because if, you know, if the first 9 reviews or the last 9 reviews, the latest 9 reviews, all say screen broke within 2 days because glass is crap, you might try a different vendor for that.
Or just stop dropping your phone.
Or get an OtterBox or a LifeProof case. You know, my phone was perfect until I took it out of the LifeProof case, and within 72 hours the screen was shattered. So, you know, apparently I have problems.
Yeah, you do. But if you like the show, you should subscribe. DieTrying.com. Sorry, that was really rude.
Find out what other problems I might have. YouTube.com/DieTrying. @DieTrying if you want to tweet. But if you want an extended email relationship with Michael, you should email.
DieTrying@Revision3.com. I'm not going to commit to that, but I might respond.
Yeah. Yeah, it's just a ring.
I'll read it for sure.
Man has trouble with commitment. Oh my goodness. You though. Commit to us, DieTrying, at YouTube.com/DieTrying. I'm Patrick Norton.
I'm Michael Hand.
We'll see you next week.
That was really weird.